Hello and welcome to IndiaPostLive.com, India's first live and interactive news conversation web TV. I'm Prachi Jatanya. A layer of foundation, a dab of mascara, some kajal, and a bit of lipstick. Is that all it takes to make women look good? Or maybe not. The no makeup selfie campaign has got a lot of people talking on the social media forum. We'll try and make a little bit of sense about it. Here's a look.
Is your makeup bill pinching your pocket? Too lazy to do your face for a party? Or you simply don't care for a made-up look? Well, in that case, you are being the most fashionable. Yes, the no makeup look is the in thing in the world of fashion today. It was the 81-year-old actress Kim Novak who had walked the red carpet at the Cannes Film Festival. She was criticized for her no makeup look. Soon, it snowballed into a no makeup selfie campaign by actors and authors. Back home, Bollywood divas Deepika Padukone, Sonam Kapoor, Priyanka Chopra, Sunny Leon and Neha Dhupia also went barefaced to show support for the no makeup campaign. Surely, beauty and fashion is being redefined by today's women.
And to get us more perspective and some interesting tips on this entire no makeup trend, is it really a trend or a fad, or is there more to it? We have joining us for the conversation in the studio, Mr. Rishi Raj. He's a makeover consultant and a fashion stylist. And we also have Nidhi Sharma, who herself is also a fashion stylist. Thank you so much, both of you, for being here in the studio on India Post Live. We also have some very interesting participants who will be joining us on Google Hangout, but more for them in a bit. I'll just ask Nidhi here, what is your take on this no makeup campaign? Is it a trend? Is it here to stay?
Yeah, it's a very new trend. In fact, 2 days back, this is a cancer awareness selfie campaign which is started by Hollywood, and following the bandwagon are Bollywood beauties from Sonam to Jacqueline. Everyone start following it, and I think it's really give you a confidence to the common women to come out barefaced.
Right. What do you think, Rishi?
Well, looking at Nidhi, I wouldn't really buy that. She has lots of rouge and lipstick on, so. I think it's interesting how the evolution of makeup and how you appear in public has really changed for women. Because I remember in the 80s, there used to be lots of garish, loud makeup. In the 90s and the 2000s to 20s, we discovered the post-production possibilities with Photoshop. And, you know, there was so much hullabaloo about post-production on images, on cover shots, cover girls and inside. Mm-hmm. And even a very famous brand also did a whole campaign on showing what really is and what it really becomes on a billboard or a hoarding.
Correct.
So I think that was kind of sending out the wrong message across to people. Also, somewhere I think the whole idea of natural beauty was getting lost. And I think somewhere these actresses, I don't think it's about really the cancer campaign. I don't think it's about any of that. It's more about, guess what, I'm pretty without makeup also. So take a look at me in a candid shot and see how pretty I look. So ultimately it does boil down to the ego and the self-image, whether there's makeup or no makeup. So I'm a little caught up in between about that, about, you know, maybe it's just a fad, maybe it's going to go on for a longer time. I think both the looks, the no makeup and the heavy makeup look, can coexist together depending on where you need to be at what time.
It's so, the occasion also that demands.
Of course.
Personally, what do you prefer in a woman or in a style icon, so to say, on screen, off screen? Is there a persona or image that they have to carry forward that they, you know, they get stuck with? What would you prefer?
What would I prefer? On a personal level, I wouldn't want to eat lipstick off anybody's face or their foundation.
Right.
So I wouldn't want that mask on my woman. Beyond that, I do feel that public figures have a certain responsibility. They owe their janta, their fans, the people who follow them, a certain aspirational value, an image to look up to. So it's important to enhance and bring out your best and be well-dressed because people do look up to you. So am I against makeup? Definitely not. I think it does a lot for people. Is it necessary all the time when you're going for a movie in the middle of the afternoon? No. You got to take a call on where you're wearing what.
So. Right. What do you think, Nidhi? Do you feel that style icons, you know, they've always had that trend? We've seen, you know, classic beauties of yesteryears, just with a bit of a bright lip shade, they attract people. They may have a nude, makeup layer there. But what is it that really stands out in one particular style style icon? Is it that lip shade or that, you know, it's because they are marketing products, they are brand ambassadors of beauty products as well. So do you feel then that they also have to carry forward that kind of image and eventually they have to sell products?
See, I personally believe that at the end they are also human beings. What if they'll step out without makeup, a bare face look? I mean, come on, it's a level of confidence they have. So yeah, it's a nice thing, and today most of the celebs, right from the Sonam Kapoor, I'm telling you, to Jacqueline, everyone stepping out of without a makeup.
Right. And so that's because, you know, if we see a Malaika Arora Khan going to drop her kids off to school, you don't expect her to turn out all her makeup and all her glory.
Yeah, actually, people do expect her to turn out with all that makeup. So yeah.
Aren't these then double standards? You know, there's so much riding. Maybe not in our industry, but in Hollywood, there's always a paparazzi in every nook and corner for celebrities. They're constantly being chased. So that really makes it tough then
To
come out without makeup.
Of course,
you know,
it does.
Have that shot in any of the tabloids splashed on the cover.
Of course. And look, but also look at the way the media promotes that shot. It's part of a tabloid. It's about somebody having cellulite. It's about somebody having a pimple. You know, so they also push it like a very negative story. Oh my God, look, you know, Kate Winslet has heavy thighs and she walked out just like that, dropping her kid to school. Or look at Nicole Kidman.
Look at the bags
know.
Under her
yeah,
eyes.
Look at the bags. So look at the way we really promote a woman's appearance ourselves in the media. So obviously there will always be pressure on them. Madonna, for that matter, even makes sure her paparazzi images are controlled. She doesn't let out anything. So there is a lot of pressure on people to kind of look pretty all the time, look presentable all the time. But, you know, it's a Damocles sword, really, I think, because come on, we are paying to watch you, so you'd better look good all the time. And at the same time, you know, it's tough to be that fake have the fake mask all the time. So it's a bit of a conundrum there.
Yes. It's a tightrope walk again. We also have Navneet Kaur joining us from Gurgaon. She's a client consulting executive with ARM Digital Media. Thank you so much, Ms. Navneet, for joining us. Hi.
I was hearing the conversation started from makeup and new makeup, and it turned about Hollywood and Bollywood. What about normal girls? You see, these Hollywood beauties and Bollywood beauties, which have a team around them, and then they get pressurized so much when you look at billboards, models. That even though maybe it is not required, you're pressurized to look that way. I think society has set a standard for girls to look like that. Why can't, and they assume that natural is not good. You understand? So these things around us every day put so much pressure on a girl to look good that her self-confidence is based on how good she looks, not on how good work she's done or how good a human being she is. And I don't understand that. And earlier you also mentioned the no makeup selfie, and you asked whether it's here to stay. It's a very good point that you brought up. I think the campaign is really good, but I am not sure how long it will stay, because there will be again advertisements and everything which will again put us in the same rut that we are trying to come out of.
Right. Great points there. I'll also get in Ms. Pallavi Gupta, who is the MD of Fifth Estate. Thank you, Ms. Pallavi, for joining us here at the Conversation on India Post Live. What are your thoughts from all the discussion and points that have come across so far?
First of all, I'll say I'm not the right person to comment on the trend of fashion. But this one point doesn't make you sense that I'm a society as a man. It's a society that shows the most beautiful things, right? So we're talking about society as a couple of points. That currently, only a couple of years back, had a society of highly assuming, right?
Ms. Pallavi, I'll just interrupt you for 1 second. We have a bit of a technical audio problem with your connection. We'll come back to you very quickly. I'll just get another male viewpoint here. Ankit, who's a media professional, is joining us also from Noida. Ankit, what are your thoughts? What would you prefer personally on celebrities or ordinary women or somebody, you know, whom you really have a fascination for in everyday life? Do you feel that makeup is essential for women?
What I feel that the celebrities,
first of all, they're endorsing these beauty products. So they have their own followers, and basically girl followers. So they tend to choose those products wisely because their taglines, their brand image is such that Sonam, maybe Sonam endorsing it, or Sonakshi Sinha, or maybe Madhuri Dixit. But there are few actresses in Bollywood, in Hindi cinema, that come out without makeup. And there are like hardly a few, from veteran actresses to new stars. There are hardly a few, like I would say, like Madhuri, maybe one that she comes without makeup in public. But it's really hard for them also because it's their image. They have to carry forward every time they go or they visit to even a temple. So they have to carry forward that makeup. And if they are not carrying that makeup on themselves, it makes the news. Because as soon as Deepika Padukone goes to Siddhivinayak without makeup, there'll be a photo on Twitter that look how Deepika is looking without makeup. And that gets a number of 1,000 retweets.
But personally, you know, what would you prefer if you're possibly dating a woman, and when you're dating a woman, what would you prefer, makeup or no makeup?
If you're possibly dating a woman, okay? I was asked that question. So.
When you're dating someone, what would your preference be?
A bit of it, but not a most of it. I'd prefer, lip gloss, not more than that.
A flavored one and that.
Interesting. We'll also try and get Miss Achal Kohli here, who's a professional, joining us. Thank you, Miss Achal. You're listening into the varied opinions coming. What is your personal view about it?
I believe that makeup is to make up for what you have, covering up the flaws, dark circles, pigmentation, whatever you have. For what you don't have, that's makeup.
Really? But I don't think so.
Yes, because I wear specs. I cannot be wearing contact lenses. And sometimes, like, I like partying, I like going out with friends, movies and all, shopping. But all the time carrying that makeup in such heat, or even in winter, it's actually not healthy for your skin. And like you asked that gentleman that, like women, like if a man and a woman are dating, so what would be a preference of a lady while at that point of time? Will she be makeup while she's going to date a man? Firstly, I can even in my glasses. One should be stable enough. One should be wearing a correct color combination, the correct pair of jeans or a t-shirt, or maybe a simple kurti and tights. And we feel comfortable. You should know how to carry yourself, basically. That's it. Simple.
I actually have a question for you. Hi. I just heard you...
Anshul,
hi. I heard you say all of that, and you talk about the color combination should be right and that's about it, or you should be in a clean white t-shirt or jeans or whatever and be able to carry yourself right. I think right when you say that the color combination should be right, you're already setting yourself up for presenting an
exactly.
image. So it is, I agree with you where you say, you know, okay, it shouldn't go to those extremes of having to wear makeup and all. But ultimately, you are already buying into the idea of projecting an image for a romantic date or a job interview. All of us, we've been taught as children that we need to be better, bigger, superior, present our best foot forward. You know, in various ways, whether it's in our education where we strive harder and mug up harder and get great marks, or whether it's in our social appearances where we have to, you know, present a face, present a certain body language. So it happens everywhere. It's ultimately your call on how you perceive it and how much you're willing to take it. You look great in spectacles. You have a great complexion. Okay, you have a very healthy skin. I can look at you right now. So maybe you don't need to do that. You don't need to do that. But another girl out there who maybe has some acne marks and still wants to put her best foot forward would want to camouflage that so that she can be more confident when she steps out. So let's not maybe treat makeup as this ultimate evil, you know, which women are forced to wear. Let's look at it as a tool that you use to maybe enhance yourself, amplify yourself in the best way possible.
Right. Ankit, yes, go ahead.
I would like to make a point that I've been living in a joint family, and I had four sisters, two cousins. So I've seen them being, growing since the age of 5 years or something. So girls have been taught.
True.
Boy, we are not taught us at our home that you have to dress like this and.
That is true. The first question a girl child.
Earrings to everything.
True.
So they have to dress properly, they have to look good.
True.
So that's an Indian culture. So that's an Indian culture, that's an Indian mindset that girls, as soon as they get
a feminine
grown
trait.
Up, as soon
I mean,
as they enter school and they have a little bit of knowledge of what is beauty exactly.
True. But isn't that sad, because every time you
they
see a little girl,
to,
the first thing you say is how cute, how pretty.
How pretty.
You don't say how intelligent or how curious the child is. You say, oh, girl, how cute, how pretty. That's the first thing you get to hear.
But I think Nidhi has a different point.
Yeah,
and I think I would possibly know what she wants to say, Nidhi.
Yeah, I mean, this is something which we raised
enjoy
to.
Doing.
Yeah, it's a feminine trait. I mean, come on, everyone
wants
to, at the end, everyone wants to look good.
True.
Yeah.
True.
So yeah, I think both of them are trying to make a similar point. The thought is that wear it if it makes you feel good about yourself, whether it's temporarily or not, if it makes you hide some flaws or makes you feel sexy or more feminine.
And come
so,
on, flaunt it if you have it. I mean, that's
right.
It.
And if you don't have it, cheat it and create it, you know?
Yeah, okay,
so if you
yeah.
If you don't have it, then also flaunt it. So it works both ways.
Right. Pallavi, would you? I think Miss Navneet wants to make a point. Navneet?
Yeah.
Exactly.
I would like to say that, yes, putting your best foot forward, as you guys have been talking about, is essential. But the perspectives of beauty have been set as so unrealistic that in order to achieve those standards, girls are getting underconfident and they are paying more attention on looks. They should not be paying so much attention on looks and be comfortable in their body in the way they are. And yes, once in a while, putting the best foot forward doesn't hurt.
Right. What I wanted to know, Rishi, also that how will the makeup industry react to a no makeup trend if it gathers steam, and if it's here to last at all? If more and more celebrities, you know, we've also seen Beyonce, Rihanna, they are actually major youth and style icons across
sure.
the world, across
sure.
age groups,
sure.
not just among women but among young girls. So,
sure.
if it's here to last, how will the makeup industry react to it?
Come on. I mean, look at the percentage of women out there who are wearing makeup. Even let's not even just talk about celebrities, you know. That's a very niche thing over there. There are enough women out there who are still wearing makeup, proudly wearing makeup, and also choosing at times not to. So the percentage is too small to really affect the cosmetic industry. The cosmetic industry right now should be more worried about this young girl who's launched a software and a 3D makeup printer. Which really creates this whole bridge between the masses and the brand.
Yeah.
Kills it completely. So they're more worried about that, where you can just scan a color of a magazine that Deepika is wearing and create an eyeshadow or a lipstick out of that. So that is their bigger worry right now. I don't think the no makeup look is really going to affect them. In fact, if brands are smart enough, they will actually latch onto this trend and create their no makeup look foundations and no makeup look lip glosses, and they'll carry on.
Right.
Even a famous
makeup.
Brand came up with a no makeup look,
course,
no makeup foundation, concealer, everything
the
they
nude,
came up with.
Looks, everybody
even
does.
Even the makeup artists are doing.
In fact, Nidhi, I'm sure knows, we work with this. The no makeup look takes far longer than adding more color, saturated colors to your face. So it's there, it's happening, and I'm sure brands will find a way to piggyback on that trend also.
Right. I'll try and go back to Ms. Pallavi also, whose connection we are trying to get. If you can hear me, Ms. Pallavi? I don't think we have it, but I'll get Archal. Archal, if you can hear me? Yes. Would you have any particular questions for our guests here in the studio? They are both very experienced fashion stylists, and please go ahead with any queries that you would have for makeup or any particular look that you'd want to create.
Ma'am, I'll definitely make that question, but first of all, I would like to reply, sir, what he questioned me, which I could not.
No, fire back.
He said that I have actually a point that when I'm stepping out of the house, I would prefer looking present every day. Definitely, why not? But in a natural way. It should not be unnatural or made up. Like, if I'm trying to put on some makeup, or I'm trying to put a proper set of sort of little dress, it should actually enhance my look.
You can't hear anything. No.
It should not happen.
Right.
It should not be suppressing my.
Niti, right?
Right. I think Anchal, if you can just hold your microphone closer to your to you, then we'll hear you clearly. Just hold it there because your audio keeps coming and going. I'll also get in Navneet here. Navneet, what do you think about the trend? I'll just, you know, digress a little bit and go into specifics about women wearing bold lip shades. The color red, you know, is also there was a trend in between,
yeah,
or there still possibly is, and maybe a stylist will focus or expand on that. But there was a trend of wearing that bright, bold red color, which not all women can carry off. What do you think?
This trend started, I was watching Discovery, and this trend started from America when the women started to go to factories and work. So the red lipstick was the sign for them to tell the world and tell the men that yes, we are out there, we are bold, and now we are going to take charge. So I think apart from being a sign of taking charge, it's a really nice thing. I mean, you're out and you're telling the world that yes, women have arrived. We are no longer going to live getting dominated by men, and we are stronger, we are bolder, and we can carry it off.
This makeup trend is more a runway trend, basically. It's more a runway trend from the Paris Fashion Week last year.
Yeah, really, makeup really goes way beyond America in recent times, or the Paris runway also, you know. I mean, if you manage to get your hands on a little bit of Desmond Morris.
Such bold colors in nightclubs and other places, and they look gorgeous.
No, but highlighting a one feature in your mouth and of your face is the main trend last year, till last year.
Right.
Yeah.
But then do you think that we need to be, you know, use some discretion? Not all women can really carry off the color red. At least I can't.
Yeah, I guess that's where a makeover consultant really comes in. So yes, it's important to know. See, aesthetics differ in every community. What may be gorgeous to you and beautiful to an Indian woman is not what, let's say, a Westerner or even an African would follow. In Africa, it's considered beautiful if you have an iron ring around your neck for every year of your life post puberty. You know, that's their look, which they think is extremely beautiful. Or putting a metal plate in your lower lip, that's considered beautiful for them. Tattooing your face is considered beautiful. Each community has its own extremes of aesthetics that they follow. And believe me, there are young women like you out there in every community who are fighting against that, wanting to change that. So it's up to you guys about how much you get influenced by those celebrities who do tend to be completely made up all the time, or do present an image where that is the ultimate in beauty. That is what you need to do. It's up to you guys to take care of that.
Right. We also have Pallavi again joining us. Pallavi is very keen to add in her views also for this entire conversation. Pallavi? I believe there's an audio glitch. I apologize to the viewers. But I'll get in one final view from Ankit here. Ankit?
The Madhuri fan.
Yes. It seems to be that Ankit is a Madhuri Deepika fan.
He knows his Deepika. He knows his Madhuri. Like that.
No, just to make one last final comment. My comment would be that girls should be confident enough.
There seems to be a technical problem. I apologize, but I was really asking you about the color red because it, you know, it got a lot of people talking about it. There were women who were able to carry it off, and it was something like, if your style icon can wear it and pull it off, so can I. But it doesn't suit all complexions, all skin types. So what would your advice or tip be to women who would want to sport that bold red color?
See, there are hues of red out there. You should really should focus on the undertones in your skin of what your complexion is and work a red according to that. From a cherry red to a, you know, fire engine red to a letterbox post office red, you know. There are various kinds of red, a rustish red. So it really depends on your complexion. I mean, across the globe, people have various pigmentations happening. You choose the one that works for you. And there are so many brands out there who help you, free advice they give you on trying out things and sampling things. Take, make that effort. Don't just blindly follow trends and fads, which is something which is all of us always say, you know, don't blindly do that. Do something that works for you.
And any makeup trend that one should watch out for all our viewers, if both of you can give in one makeup trend that could, you know, land in India, or that's something that Indians are already, you know, possibly that that could be emulated abroad from India.
Maybe. For me, it's the winged eyeliner trend. Oh. I love that trend.
Yeah, actually the retro looks are coming back in a big way. Whether it's the 1950s retro pin-up girl look or even a flapper girl because of the Great Gatsby, that's back in a big way. So of course winged liners and brighter lips and all of that is going to be a lot in fashion. But again, it's not about blindly following something and taking it for what it is and just replicating it. It's about making it work for you. So as long as people know that, I think everybody's going to look pretty.
Interesting. I'll just get one final view. I'll give Pallavi's connection a try again. Pallavi?
I see.
Hey, it's a bit choppy, but I think I can hear you.
Right. We're just discussing possibilities of makeup and no makeup trends, but what are your personal views, if you can just possibly repeat them for us?
I think I would want to have or state a different perspective to the question you asked for, right? Okay, can you hear me fine?
Yes, but there is a bit of an echo around you. We'll just get our team to look into that. One final comment coming in from Archel. Archel, before we go, what would be that one trend that you would look out for? Because you go to a lot of clubs and also in social gatherings. One makeup trend that has stood out for you or will stand out for you in the days ahead?
Well, I really like that smoky look. Like when you go to a nightclub, I like that smoky eyes and that. Especially when we're talking about that red color, like that Ruby who was in last year. And even I bought that shade from the MAC. And personally speaking, yes, I have to be dressed up in a bright shimmering dress with smoky eyes and red lipstick, but only in nightclubs.
Okay, great. I'll get one final view from Namneet also. Namneet, one look that you would personally want to sport the next time you'd go to a social gathering.
My favorite look was the smoky eyes, but now I think I really love the entire high-waisted pants look. I love high-waisted pants and high-waisted skirts. I think that's really coming in.
Mm-hmm. Right, and you feel that one must be comfortable in their own skin and with themselves to carry off makeup.
Pants of what knowledge I have is does not suit all body types. So it should be worn by only specific body types. Especially a pear-shaped person should avoid, an apple-shaped person should avoid the high-waisted pants. But otherwise, I think it's a trend and makes you look good.
Right. Namneet, I was asking, personally, you'd feel then that a woman needs to be comfortable with her own self, whether she's with makeup or without it.
Yes, completely. I think she needs to be comfortable in her own skin and not think about the standards that the makeup industry especially has set as the beauty standard, that this is how a woman should look. It's okay, you have heavy thighs, so what? You have a pretty face, and if you have some freckles on your face, so what? You have like, you're tall, you're beautiful, and just you should focus on your good parts, on your enhanced features, rather than pulling yourself down on the little flaws that you have.
Right, I think we'll try Archil on the phone, possibly. Archil, if you, I know you have a view and a strong one at that for the entire conversation. Achal, and also Pallavi, I'll try and get Pallavi's connection. Pallavi, if you could just join us on the phone line maybe, or if you can hear me.
I can hear you if you can hear me.
Yes, just go ahead with your view.
Well, I don't think I can comment on what kind of trend I like, but I think what we all want is an unassuming society, in the sense that if I'm made up and I'm standing in front of a person, the person shouldn't think she definitely is overcompensating for some of her, you know, inabilities.
Sure.
Or if I'm not wearing any makeup, so-called comfortable in my skin, the person looking at me shouldn't be assuming, geez, man, you know, you should be presentable. So I think either way, the whole question that you're asking me or asking other people is that what sort of, would you want to go out with a woman who dresses up or looks good? It's a fallacy in itself. If you are standing up for a non-judgmental perspective of people. So if you ask me that question, would I want to go out with a man who wears makeup, for example, you know, foundation, because I know a couple of men do. I would say, well, maybe that isn't really a criteria. The criteria is whether that person is capable enough to speak with me, can carry on a conversation, has a good sense of humor. So the whole point that we are saying that we like, you know, I mean, that's not to say that the person turns up in front of me in a gothic look. You know, I should be unjudgmental enough to say he or she might have the skill I need. Just to close my argument, we can extend this conversation we are having here to what a person is wearing, to whether the person has tattoos, has piercing, or things like that. So to me, it boils down to whether we are standing in front of a judgmental society or non-judgmental society.
Sure.
Right. Great point. Of course, we were trying to scratch the surface and look beyond the makeup trend, and that's why we brought up, because the No Makeup Selfie campaign itself raised about $2 billion for cancer research in the UK, and it was something that we saw a lot of women on social media forums very proudly posing with no makeup. So we'll definitely be looking forward to more comments and views from all of our participants there. Thank you so much to Achal, Ms. Navneet Kaur, Ankit and Pallavi for being so patient with us and for varied views and inputs, and also to our very interesting studio guests here, both of you, Mr. Rishi Raj and Nidhi. Thank you so much for your very interesting inputs and tips and advice for all our viewers. And we'll just, before we wrap up and take this post conversation online at the rate India Post Live, you can also put in your audio and video comments on our website, indiapostlive.com. It's something that we are not really advocating or promoting. We are actually discussing the makeup versus no makeup trend and what personal preferences are all about. And of course, you know, we've had Rishi given various views of what one must really feel as an individual, and you know, try and cater to what your likes are. So definitely put in your views, and we'd love to hear and get your participation on all our conversations. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you to all our participants and guests here in the studio as well. Thank you so much. Goodbye.